केएमएम की धुन में चलो इस तरह, केएमएम की धुन में चलो इस तरह कि मेरी मंजिल तय है बस।
सिंस यू आर स्पीकिंग अबाउट इंडिया एंड सिंस यू विल बी टेकिंग द प्रोग्राम इन द मंथ ऑफ अगस्त, अगेन समथिंग अबाउट सम इंसिडेंट्स फ्रॉम द लाइफ ऑफ सम ग्रेट पीपल। Again, these are stories which you may not have heard, but these are the small, small anecdotes which teaches us quite a lot in this world. I have tremendous respect for two people, Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore and Mahatma Gandhi. Two of them had an extraordinary relationship with each other. So much so that the name Mahatma was given by Rabindranath Tagore to Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, and the name Gurudev was given by Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi to Rabindranath Tagore. So imagine when the two of them are meeting, one is telling the other Mahatma and the other is telling the other Gurudev. Can you imagine the kind of relationship? And they had super strong differences of opinion. Their relationship was not a relationship where they agreed. They had fantastic respect for each other's intentions. They had fantastic respect for each other's capabilities. But they had super strong differences of opinion on many things. Like Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore would say, Britishers are contributing so much for our country, why do you have to fight? Rabindranath Tagore would say, India has never had democracy in its entire existence. We have always been ruled. It has always been a land of kings and queens. This part of the world does not know democracy. So if you think through democracy we will progress, show me proof. Now this is a logical mind. And Mahatma Gandhi would say, no, we need Swarajya. That was history, that was different situations. This is a different situation. Gurudev was also given OBE, Order of the British Empire, which would lead to knighthood, which is the highest respect Great Britain can give to any human being. And he received it with a lot of pride. And many people in the country were against it. Of course, later on, Gurudev gave it up after Jallianwala Bagh massacre. That an empire which kills people like this, I don't want to be respected by them. Mahatma Gandhi was invited to Shanti Niketan. Now, Shanti Niketan is a university which was created and established by Gurudev. Now, here lies two beautiful incidents which I wish to share with you. They had some debates, and as Bapu was leaving, in the visitor's diary, you know what's a visitor's diary? When you go to a particular place, they have this diary, your opinion is required. Bapu writes, if you have given a commitment, even at the cost of your life or death, honor that commitment. Mohandas. Now this place is created by Gurudev. In the visitor's diary, below what Mahatma Gandhi has written, Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore writes his comment on the comment of Bapu. And Gurudev is writing over there, in case you have given a commitment, and you realize your commitment is wrong, abandon your commitment. And when somebody asked, but how can you contradict Bapu? He says, I have tremendous respect, but I have a difference of opinion. Just because I respect a person does not mean we can't have difference of opinion. I mean, it is ridiculous to say, because I respect you, I agree to everything you say. And it's ridiculous to believe if somebody does not agree to your point of view, they are against you. on that matter, in that topic, there is a difference of opinion. That's it. And Gurudev would go to explain. The entire Bhagavad Gita happened because of this issue with Bhishma Pitama. He gave a commitment. He realized 1,000 times his commitment is wrong. But because he had given a commitment, he lived by that commitment and it devastated two big families. What happened? Is it an ego trip? If I am wrong, I am sorry I am wrong. And both of them will laugh and carry on the conversation and debate on another topic. Now this is called respect in relationships, where I can accept differences of opinion with a smile. Many times in life, we go through chaos in relationships, whether it's husband and wife, again. Whether it's parents and children, whether our colleagues at office, whether it's friends. If we have a difference of opinion, we immediately become intolerant. And it leads to a lot of hurt. As the kids grow up in life, there are bound to be differences of opinion. But one thing that we need to do is always carry respect in our heart for others. So when you send a few of these children back in some of the classrooms, you can say this story and say, I respect them. They might be very good people. I bless them and I pray they will be very successful in life. But this session is not meant for them. So whatever negativity is there in the air, you clean that negativity and then you carry on with the class. In those classrooms where this is not an issue, anyway speak about this story and say, develop the ability to respect people even when there is a difference of opinion. And you will find your ability to relate with people will be really beautiful and amazing. It was 1940s. It was very clear that the Britishers have to leave and go. Great Britain was suffering through huge losses in the wars, World War II. And more or less it was decided that we are going to leave India and go. There are some people who are good losers and there are some people who are very bad losers. A good loser gracefully exists. But a bad loser creates a lot of complications before they leave. Not only do they lose, but they ensure that the person who has won will never be happy. To them it is like that pain balm. Main haar gaya, lekin tumhari jeet mein tumko sukoon nahi milega. You know, something like that. Great Britain's policy in India always has been divide and rule. They said, we are going, but we are not going to allow India to continue to as one. They supported Jinnah. And nowhere else in the history of the world something like this has happened. They created one country on two sides of one country. Today what is Bangladesh and today what is Pakistan, in 1947 after partition was one country. And imagine one country having two parts which are not joined to each other at all. But they insisted, if we go, we will go only like this. Otherwise let lakhs of people die. At the other end, Jinnah was also insisting that I want to create another nation. And what is now famously known as the two nation theory was propagated. Mahatma Gandhi understood that the patience of people is running out. They are saying, thoda chota mila koi issue nahi hai, but let's get freedom. More or less in his mind also he decided that we should go for freedom. And there are enough people, especially the newspapers, who were giving an opinion that Gandhi is absolutely wrong and he will be the cause of the destruction of entire country. Now imagine the weight on the shoulder of a man who has to decide yes or no. Now it is not about choosing the color of his shirt. It is about the destiny of 250 million people on one shoulder. Gurudev understood the difficulty that Bapu must be going through. He was again invited to Shanti Niketan, said, come to Shanti Niketan and take a decision aramse. Gurudev had given a commitment to somebody else the day Bapu was supposed to arrive. That was the right commitment, not the wrong commitment. So he told Bapu, I will not be there to receive you. Somebody else will receive you, but I will join you very soon. You know, this is another beautiful way. No formalities. Aisa nahi, wo aa raha hai, main nahi rahunga, wo kya sochega? अरे उसमें बुद्धि है तो अच्छा सोचेगा. बुद्धि नहीं है मैं होऊंगा तो भी उसको कुछ गर्व लग सकता है. नहीं है, नहीं है, लेकिन कुछ कमिटमेंट दिया हुआ है, आप आओ आराम करो. एंड ही रोट अ सॉन्ग फॉर महात्मा गांधी. एंड महात्मा गांधी वुड से द बेस्ट गिफ्ट दैट गुरुदेव हैज गिवन टू मी इज दिस सॉन्ग. देर वर थाउजेंड्स ऑफ चिल्ड्रन लाइनिंग द रोड्स ऑफ शांति निकेतन व्हेन महात्मा गांधी अराइव्ड. And the song that was sung was, Jodi tor dak shune keu na ashe, tobe ekla chalo re. Which means, if you call out to somebody for help and nobody responds, metaphorically it also means, if there is nobody in the world who understands what you do and why you do, don't bother. Walk alone. Jodi tor dak shune, केव ना आशे तो भी एकला चलो रे. वॉक अलोन. दिस इज व्हाट करेज इज ऑल अबाउट. माय एबिलिटी टू वॉक अलोन. जब काली घटा छाए, जब अंधेरा सच को निगल जाए, जब दुनिया सारी डर के आगे सर अपना झुकाए, तू शोला बन जा जो खुद को जलाकर जहां को रोशन कर दे. यदि तुर डाक सुनियो केव ना आशे तो भी अकेला चलो रे. द मोस्ट अमेजिंग पीस ऑफ पोएट्री दैट आई लिसन टू फ्रीक्वेंटली नाउ, दिस इज लाइक माय एंथम सॉन्ग. एवरी टाइम आई एम इन अ क्रॉसरोड ऑफ लाइफ I listen to this song. Jodi tor dak shune keu na ashe, tobe ekla chalo re. Walk alone. If I have respect at one end towards people, and if I have courage at the other end for myself, no power in the world can stop me from living a life of greatness. If I don't have respect for others, neither do I have courage in my heart. No power in the world can help me to live a life of greatness. So respect for others and courage for my life. We will send you to link to this song. Every time in life when you are in a little doubt, just listen to this song. It will refresh you completely. Even if you don't understand the other words. Akla chalo, akla chalo, akla chalo, akla chalo re. These words can be memorized by you. Somebody is not understanding you. You don't have to look at them with anger. Look at them with smile. And in your mind, just sing. Akla chalo, akla chalo. Don't look at them and say, akla chalo, akla. Thoda gadbad ho jayega. वो अकेला चलने ही नहीं देगा और मैं भी साथ में चलेगा, किधर जानेगा, चल. Now those of you who have a sweet voice, which I believe everybody has, and if you have the courage, you can take the class with you in the singing of this song also. So which means what you will do is, you will go to the class and you will tell them the background and then you will tell, I'm going to sing the first lines. And then all of us will sing in chorus. Akla chalo comes four times and the fifth time it's like the ending. So it's like, tobe akla chalo, akla chalo, akla chalo, akla chalo re. And the first lines are, jodi tor dak shune keu na aashe tobe. You will go till Taube and then let the whole class sing in chorus. Akla chalo, akla chalo, akla chalo, akla chalo re. Let's do it. Jodi tor dak shune keu na ashe tobe ekla cholo ekla cholo ekla cholo ekla cholo re. Tell the children, hold on to this as an anchor for the rest of your life, and then we move into the session. So you speak about Gurudev and then you move to this part of the speech, and that is, today I am going to teach you on how to achieve any dream, any goal of your life. You can think as big as you want. If you want, you can say, I want to develop a colony in Mars. Not an issue. If you want, you can say, I want to become the prime minister of this country. Not an issue. If you want, you can write, I want to be richer than Bill Gates and Warren Buffett combined. Not an issue. If you want, you can write, I should be richer than the money of all the politicians put together. Write down an extraordinary goal that you want to achieve in your life. And I will share with you the mantra to achieve that goal. Do it in less than 30 seconds. The biggest goal that you can think of. Write it down. Biggest goal that you can think of. Without fear. That goal, achieving which will fill you with all the pride in the world. So if Tarandeep says centers all over the world, we heard that goal once. Fair enough, let it be so. Biggest goal that you can dream of. Last session was devoted on being responsible for the world, making this country a better place to live in. This session is devoted to let me grow fantastically in my life. Written? Now don't copy what your neighbor has written. If the neighbor is lady and she has written, I want to be a mother of two children, how will you write that if you're a guy? Okay, ready? You will make the children inside the classroom write down an incredible goal of their life. Listen to a few of them say, pick up four or five. And don't ask, who wants to share, please raise your hands, don't do that. Identify people inside the classroom, involve them. Ask them, okay, what do you think is the goal that you have written? Just listen. To every goal that they speak, give a positive adjective back. Lovely, brilliant, marvelous, superb. Don't listen to one and say, Not allowed. Because that might be an incredible goal for them. If you don't understand, then say all the best. And then you will say, in life, you don't get what you desire. You only get what you deserve. There are some things which are a gift. Birth in India, a human, born to a family where there is love and affection. These are all his gifts. But if I have a desire for something, the rule of life is, I don't get what I desire, I get what I desire. Now, this is a statement given to us by Zig Ziglar, who says, in life you don't get what you desire, you get what you deserve. I desire a fit body, but do I deserve a fit body? I desire great relationships, do I deserve great relationships? I desire a lot of love, do I deserve a lot of love? I desire a beautiful organization. Do I deserve a beautiful organization? I desire a lot of appreciation, focus, endorsement, validation. Do I deserve all these things or not? I desire for exceptional friends. Do I deserve it or not? I desire a lot of support. Do I deserve it or not? I desire great success in my life. Do I deserve it or not? If desires were everything, then this whole world would have become a chaos. And understand, that is why existence has created this rule. How many times mother, very upset at the child, can either say or think, mar kyun nahi gaya? Paida hota hi mar jata? And imagine if all the desires become real. Forget about this. You see a movie, and let's say in the movie you see, who's an unmarried, unattached heroine today? Khushbu? Ha, heroine. Sorry, I should have asked you about hero, na? Priyanka Chopra. Okay, theek hai, Priyanka Chopra. Now imagine, you see a movie and you desire Priyanka Chopra. Arey yaar, ek bar mil jaye. But after 5 seconds, your neighbor has the same desire. And Farah Khan, whose movie is under production, she has the same desire. So poor Priyanka Chopra will only be in the air, rotating from here to there. Imagine, you look at my shirt and say, kya shirt hai yaar? If only I had this shirt. Next moment, what happens to my shirt? Now don't imagine about my pants. So, existence created this rule that if I give people what they desire, the whole world will become chaos. So, to whom to give? Because existence believes in abundance. It believes in giving. But it wants to give in a way which will create you and not destroy you. So I desire for many things in life. Existence says, let me find out you really desire it or not. Okay, if you deserve it, I'll give it to you. So therefore in life, you don't get what you. You only get what you. This is an existential rule made for our benefit. And between desire and deserve, there is always a gap. There is always a gap. So today, let's say we desire and keep moving movement to transform the education system of the country. But today, do we deserve that kind of a power or connection? Today we don't. So it is not coming to us. One day we will. That time it will come to us. Today, between the desire and deserve, there is a gap. Are all of you with me? This is what we are going to tell the children. Make it humorous so that they understand just by desire things won't happen in life. I need to deserve them. And then we will create a rule, a formula by which the gap between desire and deserve is going to get bridged. This gap is bridged by 4 words. And these 4 words is what is required. Those of you who know the 4 words, there is one small twist which is coming. The first thing which bridges the gap between desire and deserve. Just before I say it, do you want to know?
Yes.
Because if I give you this formula, anything that you desire in life can become yours. Anything. So you need to have that huge urge to know about it. First thing which will be required is effort. Without efforts, what you desire never becomes what you deserve. And when I say effort, it has to be enough efforts, the required efforts. Like I exercise twice a week and I say, bahut effort dal raha hai, vajan kam hi nahi ho raha hai. But because I exercise twice a week, I ate double 7 days. So my effort is not enough. So the question that you ask yourself is, for you to convert what you desire into something that you deserve, how much effort will be required? First, understand that. Let's say some of you are businessmen over here and you say, I want to increase my profit twice, 100% more. Okay, to increase your profit from today, let's say an X amount to 2X, what is the effort which is required? Are you willing to put that effort? I want to make great friends. I should be surrounded by people. For that, what is the effort which is required? Now, Sumit loves to exercise. And Manan today has decided to drop how many kgs? 25. Now imagine, Manan says, I've got time nahi hai yaar. Then he tells Sumit, ek kaam kar, gold gym mein na, maine annual membership le liya hai, roj tu ja ke exercise karna, vajan mera kam hona chahiye. Now if he wants to be fit, who has to put efforts? Sumit? Manan. Manan has to put efforts. So if I want something in life, I can't depend on somebody else to put efforts. I have to put efforts. So step number one, whatever effort is required, I should be ready to put in. Are you with me? Yes. Step two, the efforts must be self-motivated efforts. Going back to the earlier session, not dependent on others to motivate me, step number one of self-belief, but step number two, I must be self-motivated. What do I mean by self-motivated? Self-motivation has three parts. To understand, if I am self-motivated or when I am self-motivated, I do not give up at obstacles. If I give up on obstacles, I am not self-motivated. Two, when I'm self-motivated, I give a little more than 100%. When I'm not self-motivated, I will do something for the sake of doing, not with 100% involvement. Which means I don't care who's watching, who's not watching. I am self-motivated, so I am going to give my 100%. And the third thing that happens through self-motivation is, you have fun in the entire process. When I don't have self-motivation, I suffer the work. When I'm self-motivated, I enjoy the work. These are the people who can relax as they work. Who don't go home to relax. आज बहुत काम किया बाप रे अभी मेरे को रिलैक्स करने दो. They come home relaxed. आज बहुत काम किया एकदम रिलैक्स हूं. How many of you can say that? आज बहुत काम किया इतना काम किया ना कंप्लीटली रिलैक्स्ड. दीज पीपल डोंट नीड अ हॉलीडे. देयर लाइफ इटसेल्फ इज अ हॉलीडे टू देम. नहीं नहीं चलो कहीं मजा करके आएंगे. सुबह से शाम क्या करते है? सजा और इसको छोड़ के मजा. इमेजिन अ लाइफ वेर यू आर एक्साइटेड एंड यू आर नॉट टायर्ड बाय व्हाट यू आर डूइंग. देर मे बी फिजिकल फटीग फिजिकल टायर्डनेस बट मेंटली यू आर नॉट टायर्ड एट ऑल. फिजिकल टायर्डनेस आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड. मेंटल टायर्डनेस इट मीन्स द लाइफ यू आर लिविंग इज नॉट सेल्फ मोटिवेटेड. So some of you might be that kind of children when you were in school where your parents are saying, Baba, itna mat pad. Soja. Child says, 5 baje uthao. And the mother says, nahi, 6 baje uthayenge. Usko aaram karne do. But the child is getting so excited about studies. There is self-motivation. There is fun. And if you look at them when they're studying alone, maybe they're also dancing. Maybe they're also singing. They're also doing some cartoons. Maza aa raha hai. And it can only happen when you are self-motivated. So the test to any businessman or a professional, whether you are really self-motivated about your work is not, when you come back home, you should not say, I'm mentally tired. And if you come back home saying, Baap re, start thinking of an alternative work to do. And the test to the ladies of the house also is this. If you are self-motivated about parenting, you will not say, Pareshan ho gayi hun kyunki bachcho ne aaj ye kiya, aisa kiya, waisa kiya. It's a part of the game. when you really want to achieve something in life, you must put, what is the first word?
Effort.
And the quality of effort must be self-motivated. You don't need anybody in the world to motivate you. You are having so much fun. Why do you need somebody to motivate you? That it's as simple as that. If you like watching movies, you don't need somebody to motivate you to watch movies. Or some TV serials. You're all alone, you are happy. Aaj koi nahi hai, aaram se dekhenge. You will not say, koi boli nahi raha dekhne ko, main kaise dekh sakta hun? Anyone of you go through this in home? You're all alone, you want to watch something, and you're not watching because nobody to motivate you. See an example of self-motivation. Now comes the third word. Refined self-motivated efforts. Here comes Gurudev. I start something. I'm all out for it. And I realize it can become better. I refine it. Listen carefully. Growth is always a messy affair. Anything beautiful is always a messy affair. The end looks beautiful, but the beginning and the process always involves a lot of mess. Moats is here and there into construction. At the day of the inauguration of the building, it looks spick and span and beautiful, spotlessly clean and gleaming. But if you had gone to that place 6 months ago, you would have seen so much mess. Go to any construction site and you will see so much mess. Go to any place where interiors are happening and you will see so much mess. Go to any kitchen half an hour before things are supposed to be served and you will find there is so much mess. Mess is a part of the process of creation. Creation cannot happen without mess. Now, if I have to talk about human beings, we will not be able to create ourselves without seeing enough adequate required failures. And that is why it is said, failure is an event. I am not a failure. In that I failed, this is not a failure. I want to learn how to skip. The first time I do it, it will be clumsy. I won't be able to skip even 3 times. The rope will get stuck onto my feet. And I can see, let's say, a Naina Narang skipping 200 times in a minute. And you can't even see the rope. And thak, 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 those of you who have seen Naina skip or Sheetal Shah skip, they are like anti-gravity. You look at them and you say, mere ko bhi karne ka hai. We can, provided we are willing to go through enough failures which are going to teach us what not to do and what to do. Let's connect it with the session on Swayam. S-V-A, asafalta. And with every asafalta, you don't doubt yourself. You refine yourself. When I do this, result does not come. So this is not what I will do. I will attempt something else. This is called refined self-motivated efforts. I am not waiting for somebody else to motivate me to learn. I know I am going to fail enough number of times. The world may be learning it in 50 times. I might learn in 30. I might take 100. But I'm interested in the end result. Even if I fail enough number of times, I don't care. I was speaking with Mangesh the other evening, and Mangesh was telling me the person who has scored the first rank in the CA finals this year failed 5 times in the entrance for CA. Now who cares how many times she failed? She will not be known as a person who failed 5 times in the entrance. She will be known as the rank holder, the first rank, the gold medalist in CA. You agree with me or not? When I'm ready to put self-motivated effort, it means refined. My failures are not going to create self-doubt. My failures are only going to create a smile in me which tells me, "Acha, this does not work. So let me do something else." So many people can make it happen, which means there has to be a workable way. I have not found it yet. That's it. I just refine. Never allow failures to fill you with doubt. Yesterday I had a businessman's meeting. There are about 400 businessmen when we talked about something. How many of you have heard about this director called Manoj Knight Shyamalan? Some of you heard about him? He's also directed Bruce Willis in a movie. I think the name of the movie was The Sixth Sense. And he's created a movie called Signs and a lot of movies. This guy is called the fifth best director in Hollywood. When an Indian reporter took an interview and asked, "How can an Indian be one of the best directors in Hollywood? Actors are struggling. How can a director make it so big over there? What is your driving force?" And Manoj Shyamalan says, "I have a great fear, and my fear is, will I die as a mediocre? Will I die as a mediocre? मतलब life में कितनी opportunities है, कितनी खूबसूरती है, कितने अवसर है? ऐसे ही मर जाएगा क्या? Useless, absolute mediocre, like 99% of the world." He says, "My fear is, will I die as a mediocre? Hence, I am able to challenge myself. I want to expose myself. I want to create opportunities. I want to grab even half opportunities. The fear I have is not of failing. The fear I have is of being a mediocre." So it brings us to something very beautiful. Some of us don't take a leap. We don't take chances. We don't grab opportunities because we have fear of failing. And there are some people who grab opportunities because they have a fear of being a mediocre. Both have fear. One takes the fear to drive themselves. And the other takes the fear to remain as a mediocre. So when you fail, you will have fear of what the world is going to think. You are scared of these sarcastic comments which somebody might say. Out of that fear, you can stop making positive, progressive choices. Or, you can also be scared, will this failure define my life? I want to be somebody incredible. I don't care if I fail 1,000 times. But that last success which will not define me. And that's what makes Abraham Lincoln. That's what makes a Thomas Alva Edison. Failed enough number of times. But they are not known for their failures. They are known for that one success. So what's your excuse? Therefore, when you say refined self-motivated effort, you know what I'm doing might produce result, may not produce result. If it produces result, brilliant, I'm on the right path. If it doesn't produce result, it means I need to refine myself a little. It's as simple as that. Everybody has to go through their sense of discovery in their life. The trick is to handle that fear. Will you die as a mediocre because you are afraid to succeed or afraid to fail? Hence, you did not want to take any chances. And hence, you withdrew into your comfort zone and stayed in that forever. Or are you a person who's scared of being a mediocre and therefore you can take any chance which you think has even a little percentage possibility of winning? If you are a person who says, I'm going to refine myself, I realize creation is a messy affair, then your failures cannot stop you. It only guides you. It nudges you. It actually nourishes you. So we've spoken about three things so far. Refined, self-motivated efforts. Now this refined self-motivated effort must be consistent. You do it once, not going to be enough. You need to be consistent. Let me give you two examples, one a little humorous on the lighter side, and the other which has inspired me for years. Let's say you become rich enough to buy your own helicopter. The real helicopter. Okay? Not G.I. Jones helicopter which you bought out of fun school. And let's say you went up on a tour of Pune and you have some guests with you and you are showing them all the different properties you have. And say, let's say your latest purchase has been Aga Khan Palace. And you're showing them. And let's say your relative says, thandi baj raha hai, pankha band karo na. What will you do? Pankha band. Pankha band, tu aur main bhi band. That has to go on consistently till it takes you to the destination. That's what consistency is all about. As long as it takes. I'm not going to give up in between. Neither I'm going to measure my time period with somebody else's time period. Consistency means same quality as long as it takes. There may be many restaurants which cook as well as Vaishali, if not more. I know at least one place, Naividyam. Kidhar hai Rajesh? But people go to Vaishali and they don't want to experiment with too many places because there is consistency in the quality of the food that they give. There is something called scalability of trust. With every experience that people have with you, in their head, does the trust for you increase? If yes, then you are consistent. Some of us are in a big hurry. We attempt and we give up. Consistency means as long as it takes, I am going to be at it. The fourth thing which is required for you to achieve any goal that you wish in your life is consistency. So it's not enough to take one session well. Your consistency defines your quality. It's not one day greatness. How many of you have heard about Yajuvendra Singh? 5, 6, 7. Do you know he has the world record for the maximum number of catches held by any fielder in the history of cricket? Maximum number of catches by any fielder. I think in a match he had 6 catches. Besides the wicketkeeper, of course. He was great one day. One day he was great. Who remembers him? And when I say extraordinary fielder, which name comes to your mind? consistency. You can depend on John T. Rhodes. Consistency. That separates the winners and the losers. Dreams that everybody has. Deserve, they are winners. And the bridge between the two? Consistent. Second word? Refined. Third word? Self-motivated efforts. Tell the children in the class, this is the mantra for whatever you want to achieve in your life. Aim big. Be super ambitious. Think about doing something incredible. Put it as I desire. So let them create a beautiful, you know, a circle over here where they write desire. At the other end, another circle called deserve. Create a bridge. If you have a blackboard inside your classroom, then on one extreme, left, right, desire, the other extreme, right, right, deserve, then create a bridge. Let there be a visual impact. And on that bridge, just write C-R-S-E. Write it one word at a time. First, we need to begin with efforts, because effort is the base. Everything else are qualities to effort. So begin with effort. Then speak about self-motivation and how these three things are a part of self-motivation. Then speak about how is it that we need to refine it, and there talk about the role of failures and how almost everybody has fear, and fear can be divided into two different types of people. One who are scared that they might fail and therefore they don't attempt to stay in their comfort zones. And the other who are scared they will be mediocres and they don't want to live as mediocres, hence they jump out of their comfort zones. Again, this audience will be divided into two parts when you have to do your willpower exercise of going and staying in the slums. One will be scared, oh my God, I don't know what will happen, so let me not try. Let me live in my comfort zone. I know about swimming, but I don't want to learn swimming, says this category. I know about relationship, but I don't want to practice good relationships, says this category. Knowing about is not enough. Knowing is what is required. Even if you know that they have a tough life, you don't have emotions attached to it. It's an intellectual realization. Yeah, they have a tough life. But when you go there, stay there for one night, and when you come back, you will have an experiential realization of what they go through. And that is when a magic will happen inside you. So this entire group will also be divided into two parts. And 2 weeks is quite a lot of time. Some of you will go to these schools where children from the poor sections of the society come. If you can do this exercise before you go to the classroom, you will see them with a lot more humility in your heart, love in your heart, and your ability to relate to them will be really beautiful. And I wish everybody does it. I truly, deeply wish everybody does it. What we have discussed in this hall today are not ordinary pieces of wisdom. Enough things we have discussed today, which has the power to change your life downside up. Don't just take it to speak about it in the session. In your life also, do this analysis in every team. I would love it if the area coordinator can make everybody write, okay, this is my goal. And I realize CDSE. And in CDSE, what can be the possible obstacles? And how is it that I'll prepare to overcome it? Become an intimate group where you are support system, support group to each other. When you have gone through the churning, and then when you go and stand inside the classroom and take the session, it's not going to be a vomit which will come out. It will be conviction which will come out. And that is what creates transformation. So the session is called CRSE. Consistent, refined, self-motivated efforts. May your life be transformed completely with this session. All the best. Thank you so much and love you all.
KMM ki dhun mein chalo is tarah. KMM ki dhun mein chalo is tarah. Ke meri manzil tay hai, तरह, AMM की धुन में चलो इस तरह, AMM